The first children begin arriving shortly after sunrise. At the Cité Voltaire Elementary School in Paris, they are greeted by the principal and some new security measures. To protect against the threat of terrorism, parents are urged to avoid gathering in large crowds at the entrance, and staff may now search the bags of visitors to the school.
Paris may be on edge, but that's done little to dampen enthusiasm from the kids going into school.
Laurence Trottet, who just dropped off her six-year-old son, is trying to stay positive.
Yes, but I think if somebody wants really to get into the school, it's very easy to get into the school. So we have to keep going anyway.
Across town, security measures far more stringent at the campus of one of France's most elite universities, the Paris Institute of Political Science, Sciences Po.
So right now, only students and faculty of Sciences Po is allowed in, and we've canceled all events with external visitors.
Administrators say they've raised security to the school's maximum level to reassure students who feel vulnerable.
I don't know, because the youth was definitely attacked by these terror attacks, and I think that because our school is like so politicized, if one university was to be attacked in France, it would be probably us, so it makes it scary.
Some of the French are taking matters into their own hands. This is a first aid training session taught by the French White Cross. Since the terror attacks on November 13th, the organization's president says he's seen a 20% surge in enrollment in first aid courses.
Have you ever seen so many people
not take first aid? The first time. No.
It's driven by a feeling of powerlessness, he tells me, by people who want to be ready in the event of another attack. Some things in the French capital haven't changed. This is still a place where tourists happily pose for photos. But it is also a city where armed soldiers now patrol the streets, a show of force during a time of fear in the City of Light. Ivan Watson, CNN, Paris.